Hello, and welcome to the Chemistry Solution. This tutorial is on dimensional analysis. And this tutorial is part two in a series, where we'll be covering some more complicated dimensional analysis problems. If the standard value of Earth's gravitational acceleration at sea level is 9.81 meters per second squared, what is the value in kilometers per hour squared? In this problem, we not only have to change one set of units, but we need to change two sets of units. We need to change meters to kilometers, and we need to change second squared to hour squared. We'll also be looking at how to convert a unit raised to a power. In this example, second squared to hour squared. Let's start by writing the information that we're given. 9.81 meters on the top per second squared on the bottom. We'll need a conversion factor to convert from meters to kilometers. Looking at the conversion factors we have available to us, we know that 1,000 meters is equal to 1 kilometer. And because we have meters on the top in our problem and we want meters to cancel, we'll need to put the value with the units of meters on the bottom of our conversion factor. This means that 1 kilometer must go on the top. And this allows us to cancel out the units of meters. So if we were to stop our problem now, we would have an answer in kilometers per second squared. Now we need to convert seconds squared to hours squared. And we'll look at how to convert a unit that's raised to a power. We know that we'll need to use a conversion factor, and we can see that 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute. Because we want seconds on the top, we know that minutes must go on the bottom. Now what you'll see is that we have units of seconds on the top and units of seconds squared on the bottom. This allows us to cancel out only one of the units of seconds on the bottom. Remember that seconds squared is just equal to seconds times seconds. So after we cancel out 1 units of seconds, we're still left with units of seconds on the bottom. So to convert from seconds squared to minutes squared, we'll need to apply this conversion factor again. Having 60 seconds on the top again allows us to cancel out the other unit of seconds on the bottom. So now we're left with kilometers per minute times minute, or kilometers per minute squared. Now I think the best way to solve these dimensional analysis problems is always to write out your conversion factor as many times as you need to cancel out all the units on the bottom. So because we had seconds squared, or seconds times seconds on the bottom, we need 2 conversion factors with seconds on the top in order to cancel those out. But if you'd like, you can also just square the units on your conversion factor as well as squaring the number and write your conversion factor like this. Here we have 60 squared seconds squared per 1 squared minute squared. And what you'll see we did here is we just took the conversion factor, 60 seconds is equal to 1 minute, and squared the entire conversion factor. That's the same thing we did before. This is just a more concise way of writing the same thing. And you'll see now that second squared on the top is able to cancel a second squared on the bottom. We're going to do the same thing for this next conversion factor because we know that 60 minutes is equal to 1 hour. We know that the minutes will have to go on the top and hours will go on the bottom. And here, instead of writing out the conversion factor twice, I squared the whole thing. So remember, if you're going to square the units, you also have to square the number that goes along with those units. And so here, because we squared minutes, we also need to square 60. And because we squared minutes and 60, we also need to square hours and square 1. This allows us to cancel the minutes squared on the top with the minutes squared on the bottom, and gives us an answer of kilometers per hour squared. And when you punch this into your calculator, you'll come up with an answer of 1.27 times 10 to the 5th kilometers per hour squared. Let's try one more example like this. 1 nanogram per nanometer cubed equals how many kilograms per meter cubed? We'll start by writing the information that's been given, 1 nanogram per nanometer cubed. Again, we know we need to use a conversion factor. And this time, let's convert nanometers cubed to meters cubed first. Remember, whenever you have a problem where you're converting 2 different sets of units, the order in which you convert those units is irrelevant. Now remember, a nanometer is a very, very small unit of measure. There are 10 to the 9th nanometers in every 1 meter. Or likewise, sometimes you'll see this conversion factor written 10 to the negative 9th meters is equal to 1 nanometer. These conversion factors are equal, so it doesn't matter which one you use. I'm going to go ahead and use 10 to the 9th nanometers for every 1 meter. Now looking at our units, we have nanometers cubed on the bottom and nanometers on the top. This allows us to only cancel 1 unit of nanometers. When we write this conversion factor again, now we have nanometers cubed on the bottom and nanometers times nanometers, or nanometers squared, on the top. So now we're able to cancel 2 units of nanometers. We need to write this conversion factor one more time. So we have nanometers times nanometers times nanometers on the top, and nanometers cubed, which is nanometers times nanometers times nanometers on the bottom. Writing the conversion factor 3 times allows us to cancel nanometers cubed on the bottom with nanometers times nanometers times nanometers, or nanometers cubed, on the top. You'll see that by writing the conversion factor 3 times, we'll also now be multiplying our initial value times 10 to the 9th 3 times. And this is important to do in order to arrive at the correct answer. If we were to stop this problem now, we would have units of nanograms per meters times meters times meters, or meters cubed. So we have successfully converted nanometers cubed to meters cubed. Now we need to convert nanograms to kilograms. Because the prefix nano means the same thing regardless of whether it's in front of grams or meters, you'll also see that we can use a similar conversion factor. 10 to the 9th nanograms is equal to 1 gram. And because we want nanograms on the top to cancel, we'll write nanograms on the bottom of our conversion factor. This allows us to cancel out units of nanograms. And if we were to stop this problem now, we would have units of grams per meter cubed. To convert to kilograms, we'll use the conversion factor 10 to the 3rd grams per every 1 kilogram. And we'll put 10 to the 3rd grams on the bottom in order to cancel out units of grams, and kilograms on the top. This allows us to cancel out units of grams, and now we're left with the final answer in units of kilograms per meter cubed. And when you punch these numbers into your calculator, you'll come up with 1 times 10 to the 15th kilograms per meter cubed. Thanks for watching The Chemistry Solution. We hope you enjoyed this tutorial.